Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again to Lufia and the Fortress of Doom. When we last left off, we got to level 15, we're gonna go to the next level of the old cave. Let's see. Alright. Let's go to the fourth level. For some reason, Aguro is very far behind. Down and down we go. I think I mentioned before, but I really do like that elevator effect they got going on there. You know, it's I think it's a very interesting way to achieve that effect. Well, that's not good. I think I'll have Aguro swing his weapon at the orc, and then have some high arrows on these guys. One of the high arrows plus Jaren's bow should be able to take out the red orbs. With no extra damage caused from having my own spells reflected back at me. So that's good. Yeah. Jaren's bows are very, very useful. There's three of them in the game. The elven bow is what she starts with. You get another one as part of the plot. And the last one is one of the rewards for collecting all of the dragon eggs. Alright, so we're going to do this, this, and this. Hopefully that big arrow will be enough to take out that orc. So, let me see, what we're going to do today, we are going to probably do this old cave, and, oh yeah, that's plenty of damage, and then, what else, I guess defeat the boss in the, is it Red Tower? It's one of the towers. I think that's my goals for this little recording session. This we're gonna bang and frost, I guess. I don't really know. Those blue wolves hit kind of hard. Thankfully, they don't have a whole lot of hit points. Nice. Probably could have just gotten by with just her regular attack with a bow. High magic. Let's use the sweet water. Long nails. Let's use the float spell. While we're here, let's go ahead and heal too. Lufia was at maximum hit points. Anything hidden in this? There's the crown. And the broad rod. Is that cursed? I don't remember. Yep, it's cursed. But that's not a big deal. We'll just uncurse that and whatever. I thought it was cursed, but I wasn't sure. This room. I like this room. Look at all these treasure chests. Bone helms, long swords, light robes, a buckler, a flame ring. Flame ring's really good for Jaren. Let's see, so we'll put that on her. That on a hero. Not a hero, Aguro. Well, Aguro is a hero, you know? Keep the heal shoes for later, but I don't really need it. I would say I'm about two, maybe three levels under-leveled. Bang. Bud and you. That should kill everything on the screen. Okay. Good. Those bees do not have very much hit points at all. Ooh, I like this room too. I like the room less now that half of the treasure chests are actually worthless. This'll finish these guys off. Gotta uncurse Lufia. I wonder what the broad rod actually translates to. Because I feel like some of these weapons are, especially the cursed ones, are mistranslated. The broadsword that we found earlier, you know, a broadsword is a normal, everyday sword, you know? It's not something that you would typically think to be cursed. So, why is it cursed? What is going on there? But, you know, whatever. Let's see. Buckler. And I don't need to buy light armor because I got all that stuff for free. So that's pretty good. Yes. Alright. Down we go. Here, lady, buy this crown from us. How much money do we got? 8,000? Yeah. I need to upgrade Lufia's stuff. First, let's take this off. Yeah. Whatever. I'll just take that as the price of my stupidity. Get our money back. Don't need that, or that, or that. Keep that. I don't need that. I don't need that. Okay. Doing pretty good. Sell that. Sell that. Now we're going to go back to Genova. Hold on 1 second. I have a thing that's trying to update. Let me stop it. Alright, let's see. Let's go ahead and go to the Red Tower. We're going to do it first. Because you have to do the Red Tower to unlock the stuff. Forget, is one of those... These guys are weak to... Spark. Should be able to one-shot them with the flame ring on. At least I thought I would be able to one-shot them all with the flame ring on. Close, though. Pretty close. Yeah, I think this is the next one. No, that's where we came over here at. Alright. Bang. And spark. Thank you. Oh! Not a big deal. Actually, I should probably go back to Genova now that I think about it. I want to buy some things, actually. Stay at the inn. That kind of stuff, you know. Yes. Alright, so now that we've stayed at the inn. And we do have a half-elf. Does that mean half of the road is going to open up? Who knows? Who knows? Okay, so I don't think that the attack difference is that big of a deal for the hero. I'm not going to be buying the longsword, I don't think. Should I buy the rapier, though? Nah. Alright. You're good there, we're good there. Maguro needs a buckler. And I need a glass beret. Too much of a defense boost, but it's very important for Lufia. And it didn't cost me that too much money. Got 8 high arrows and 20 big arrows. That should be plenty. Alright. Let's go to the Red Tower. Damn it! Hopefully they won't both do that. Flash. Oh, goodness. Let's hit him with a Guru to make sure that he dies. I meant to hit... skeleton with my attack from Jaren, not the spell snitch. So, yeah. Oh well. That's a pretty good level up. And she learned stronger. Basically, it's Cura. Final Fantasy terms. Close enough. Okay, let's use... Do I need to use a... I think I do need to use some sweet water. Alright. Let's go ahead and just use this frost spell. Pretty close to killing them. Yeah, nice. Jaren has a lot of useful spells, which is one of the reasons why I gave all my stuff to her. Let's do this. That should finish everybody off. I'm not too worried about my MP, but because before we go into the next dungeon, we're going to be going into a town, so. Boom. Boom. In case you didn't notice, the bombs are basically the same thing as that spell, except they don't, I'm guessing, don't take into account your intellect, and that's like the difference, but... Probably should have just had Lufia defend. Yeah. Spark, pretty good here. Yeah, we're doing okay on levels. Like I said, I am probably a level or two behind. It's not too big of a deal. Let's do one more bang spell, one more frost spell. That should hopefully take care of all these guys. Don't spew on me. That's rude. It's like super, super rude. I'll spew on you. Hit you with swords and stuff, but that's not like puking on you. This is a really interesting part of the game because of Lufia and Jiren can pretty much in a single round kill everything on the screen with their magics. Anyway, welcome to the town of Ruin. They have a beautiful lake that's become a toxic marsh. The neat thing about that is that you can walk through the marsh right now, but when you actually fix this town, you cannot walk through the water section anymore. It's an interesting little tidbit there. We're going to raid this town, and actually, I'm going to go ahead and stop. I was planning on playing for a good long time today, but, well, life, you know how it is. Emerald. This little shop just sells crappy little accessory gems that don't do anything. Five. Some sweet water. I don't think they sell anything else here besides those gems. Small knife. Oh yeah, that's gonna be super useful. Thank you, lady. You have solved our... Well, I shouldn't be mean to her. I did steal it from her. So anyway, let's go ahead and record. This one, and next time we're gonna go up the red tower, and then once you go up the red tower, it's pretty easy to go up the other two towers and get all the stuff. You have to go up all the towers once. At the top of each tower, there's a not necessarily at the top, but basically what we got to do is we got to go to the top of each tower, get a gem, and then we have to go and place the gems in a certain order. Right, and I don't remember what the order is off the top of my head. Let's see. Blues first. Tower green, you place them in blue, green, and red. But the green gem is in the blue tower. The green tower, you'll find the broken red gem, and in the last tower, you'll find the So the blue gem is in the red tower, which we're going to do first, and then the green gem is in the blue tower. So my memory didn't fail me. The ideal way to do it is you do the red tower first, you get the blue gem, and you climb the blue tower, get the green gem, put the blue gem in, then you climb the green tower and put the green gem in and find the broken gem, and then you go get the red gem from the, okay. So I'll see you guys next time.